Y'all sounded good.
Thank you.
Y'all made me want to get a pan and do a two-step and stank your leg a little bit. I'm with it. I love it. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome.
Y'all nervous?
Welcome, y'all. Welcome, y'all. We are here with the stars, y'all. We doing our Christmas thing tonight. Everybody, who going to go first? Who going to tell us? Y'all got to tell us who y'all are. We need to know these things. Introduce yourself. Tell the world about yourself.
I'm
Aurelia,
and I'm 15.
I'm Rosanna. I'm 16.
I'm Jesslyn, and I'm 15.
I'm Erica, and I'm 16.
I'm Makai, and I'm 15.
I'm Gregory, and I'm 14.
Y'all some bad singing somebody's, boys. Y'all did that. How long y'all been together?
About three, four years.
Somebody said three, somebody said four. Somebody need to figure it out. So what made y'all get together? What made y'all say, we can do this?
Church.
Shout out, we got to tell the people what church y'all go to. Shout out to church.
Y'all don't know what church y'all go to.
Pastor on Sunday, these two y'all need to be talking to. They don't know what church they go to.
All the way from Fredericksburg.
Y'all need extra Sunday school. Y'all don't know what church y'all go to. That's what's up. So, let's see. What's your position? Tell me what you sing.
Tenor.
You're a tenor?
Tenor.
Alto.
Soprano.
You a high alto girl.
As a rapper, I do not know what each position means. So please.
That mean they bad. That's what it means. They bad.
Man, we're here, man. We're here to start the form and Cozy Radio Long Song with Uncensored Network, man. What we trying to do, we know all y'all have been affected by a pandemic and we just want to bring people together. And always when I want to bring people together, I call Miss Tamika Joy in. She take care of the hard work. So, man, I appreciate all y'all for being. It's going to be a great, we're going to give our prizes. It's going to be a lot of tears, a lot of joyful, man. We're bringing it together. This is an Uncensored Network event, not just Cozy Radio. As a whole event, man.
And before we let them get up out of here, come on. You know you can't get away with all this. Come on. Let's go. Because she over here choir directing her life away.
Yeah.
Yes, go ahead, Mom. Tell them who you are.
I'm Sinestra Whiting, and these are kids that are in a choir together, but they decide to get together just to do something on the outside.
Let me say this, lady. I watched this lady live, and she's so... I watched it live this morning.
Okay,
I know.
Okay.
I like this. So, everything.
During the season. Well, I mean, it's all about giving back. It's not really about receiving, and that's what we instill in our kids. So this is something that they wanted to do. They want to get outside the walls of the church. You know, so just to do extra things, and that, you know, that's how we encourage our children, just to do more, go that beyond step, you know. So they do awesome. That one's
all great. Y'all close to being grown. Stay your butts in church. You do whatever you want to do outside church, take your butt back to church. I'm going to tell you now, at 30, you're going to run back. You're going to walk away today, but you're going to run back at 30. So stay there. You ain't got to never run back.
But keep on, you know, doing what y'all doing, because this is just a wonderful thing. Tamika knows anytime she calls, I'm like, yes.
That's like me. Let's do it.
Well, shoot, I'm about to come get me some choir lessons.
This was good.
Right now, I'm going to give all y'all a gift.
Thank you so much.
Oh,
sorry.
She said the
gift from
the stars, sometimes
they
fly. Because I know they're
getting ready to go, so I don't want to miss out. Thank you. But thank y'all so
much on the behalf of stars. Hold on, where you going at? While
Miss Joy is
here.
Boom,
she put it together.
She did that. Now we're going to talk about the future a little bit. This is not just a one-time thing, man. We trying to get back to community, give back to the youth. We know y'all been suffering the most of all that, because I don't remember a time when I was this young and had to go through this. We all used to play basketball, go to rec centers, or be able to do so. I'm so glad that all y'all kids is in good spirits and everything.
Thank you so much, you, Mimi, Brian. Thank y'all so much for inviting us. Like I said, I definitely don't
know. Girl, you home.
This ain't the first, and this won't be the last. So, enjoy the show, you guys.
Yes. Thank you guys for coming out and sharing your talent with us. We definitely got to bring y'all back, because y'all did that. I loved it. Y'all blessed my heart. And we just hanging out with the young
people. Yeah, we just hanging out, man.
We just got invited.
Yeah, that's it. So, we're going to show this video. We'll be right back with the next interview and the next performer. Let's go.
Yeah.
But I'ma buy you Louis. Yellow stones on my wrist remind me of a slush. So fine, won't arrive it like a husband. Ugly girls quiet, pretty girls wild. Country girls see the girl, yellow black diamond. Got her in the bed with the kid, now wild. To the club on the three Long Island. She from Long Island, Atlanta, I reside in. Big black diamond, bigger than a black razor. Asian, black, dark Asian, a blazing, a blazing. So persuasive, it's amazing how they stand there, cause they're blazing. Wasted to the perfect time of everybody to show observation. Tell me that you're such a crazy girl.
Okay, my name's Wale, you probably know me from the, you know. Boss in my Hugo, boss like my Tupo. Flow is on Pluto, the Rollins ain't Pluton. I have a people know who wants to sell my Negro. Yeah, I can do they fall. Okay, just clap, clap. Okay, just clap, clap. Okay, just clap, clap. Okay, just clap, clap. Okay, just clap, clap.
Okay, just clap, clap. I like it.
What's up?
Bye.
She's moving, she's grooving, dancing until the music stops now. Yeah.
What it do, what it do, and we are back. Once again, your girl Mimi Ottagaff is in the building with your man Bam 640.
We you dig me?
We doing Christmas with the Stars, y'all. We got my man Joe. What it do, Joe?
What's up?
How you doing?
I'm good.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You look confident, though. You
right,
ain't scared.
Right. My man,
you've like done this before. You done this before?
No.
This your first interview?
Yeah.
You real comfortable being on your first interview, right, man. You like, I'm chilling, I'm here.
Man,
I'm
you
good.
Look like you just sold a platinum album and sitting down with BET or MTV or something.
Well, I'm trying to be. Can't show
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying?
So I'm saying, though, I heard you make some luck. I don't look big on the outside, but, like, in my soul, though, I'm a big girl. And I heard you make some food that's, like these pastries and stuff is, like, the die for.
Yeah, I do.
Oh, he's so modest. Yeah.
Yeah, I started, like, a couple months ago.
Hold on, wait a minute. A couple months ago? Yeah. You just started cooking a couple of months ago?
Yeah, pretty much.
I've been cooking since I was 13. I still can't make
right. I still ain't came up with no minutes to make no cakes and cookies. What the world? I'm doing something wrong in my old life.
So how you get in that? So what made you just to try that out as a career?
Well, since coronavirus and stuff, we've been quarantined and stuff. So
coronavirus bringing out talent out of everything.
I was just thinking, and I was just being bored sitting in the house. I was like, I want to make money. So I went to my aunt's house, and she was like, you know, you should start baking and stuff since that's what you like to do and all that. And ever since then, she told me the recipe for stuff and all that, and I just started doing it. And then from
oh,
there, just kept going.
Oh, auntie gave you all the hookups. She gave you all the recipes and everything.
Her so and my grandma.
Auntie. So when you make your first million, you know you owe auntie and grandma some money, right? Okay, as long as you know.
$500,000 a piece.
Yeah, they need your houses, cars, furs, the whole 9 yards, because they gave you all the good old recipes.
Everybody going to be good.
That's what I'm talking about. So what's your favorite subject in school? Let's start here. What grade are you in?
I'm in seventh grade.
You in seventh grade. And how old are you?
I'm 12, turning 13 next month.
Happy early birthday.
Thank you.
Yes, happy early birthday. So you about to be 13 years old. Already started your own business, you make what, pies, cakes, everything? Mm-hmm. You just making it all.
And soon enough, I'm learning now in the process of learning, but I'm going to start making like soul food and all that stuff.
Oh, hold on, wait a minute. You already in expansion mode? Like you just started. You already in expansion
mode? So what's
mode,
the name of the soul food?
Well, my name right now is Joe Sugar Shack because I make like cakes
Joe
and desserts.
Sugar Shack.
Joe Sugar. Yeah. Hey, that sound like boom 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 right there.
Joe Sugar, Sugar Shack. Hey, look, don't Joe, y'all try to steal it, man. Right?
Look,
don't
we need
steal
a jukebox.
It. Don't.
That's a good name.
Thank you.
I can see that on a building. That look like somewhere
so
I can hang out.
So Joe Sugar Shack gonna have cakes, the soul food, the whole shebang in it.
So you're going to have a...
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Like, you need
and I actually have my name on my sweatshirt right now.
Let me see.
Yeah, Joe Sugar Shack. Yeah, y'all are going to have a... He bred it already.
Size
you
know
me. What y'all
know
about.
That. Go ahead. That's what I'm talking about, young man. That's what I'm talking about. Advertise yourself. That's yep. Right. That is what's up.
Has anybody ever stopped you and say, what's that is? Or do you wear it often?
Sometimes
you gotta
stuff.
Wear that everywhere. The grocery
yeah,
store, the gas station, everywhere. 7-Eleven might be the best marketplace
right now.
Right
you gotta
there.
Put that on everything, like everything, literally.
Soon enough, I'm gonna be getting like a mask and
well, you let
all
us
that
know,
stuff.
Yeah, we
I
definitely
like the
about
name.
One.
I wear that.
I got you.
I wear that. Joe Sugar Shack. Yeah, I'm there all day. Know me. So, what's your favorite thing to make?
Yeah, that was my question. Bam, we on the same page. Because I'm hungry right now.
Right, he got me hungry too. I'm looking at this cake back him.
Well, the favorite thing is pound cake because, one, that's what I get asked most to make.
Mm-hmm.
But I also do, like, double layer cakes that I get asked for a lot.
You know, my birthday in March, though. Oh, that's that's that cake I'm waiting to cut right there. I'm waiting on that.
Oh,
that,
man.
That's
so, what's the name of
that
cake?
That thing right there.
Oh, that's a lemon pound cake with lemon glaze.
Boy, you my man.
Interview over. Let's go eat the cake.
But most of the stuff that I make is homemade. So the pound cake is homemade. I do some pies that's homemade, cookies, banana bread. So
let me ask you this:
man,
you do
kick
you
it, man.
When you right? He doing the thing. So when you making your desserts, right? Are you catering to people with allergies or who can't eat gluten?
I'm getting into that soon.
Okay.
My family and stuff. They're helping me look for like cookbooks and all that stuff
okay.
that like without gluten and all that stuff because mm-hmm. certain people can't.
Right.
Have it so soon enough I'll get that and then start advertising that more and stuff so
let me tell you something young man to be 12 years old and to be doing what you are doing and to have brought that beautiful cake in here wrapped the way that it's wrapped I would have never thought that cake came from a child ever I thought you brought that for us trying to be nice from the bakery
thank you
with that being said you are on your way, young man.
Thank you.
And I am honored to have been able to sit here and have this interview with you because I can say, I was there when he brought us the lemon cake. And when I eat it, I'm going to be all over the internet talking about it. So just know I'm about to just be like, all on the internet.
Thank
real
you.
Man, I'm surprised how confident you is. You look real like, I was telling you, you look like you just sold a million records. Man, you confident, man.
So outside of your grandma and your auntie, other than liking candy, because every child likes sweets.
Not me.
What?
Hold I don't like me. Candy.
How you make sweets and don't like sweets? How that work?
Like, I don't like candy, like all them sweet tarts and all that
like
stuff.
Like the real sweets. You need cookies
yeah,
and cakes.
Yeah,
and
that I like, but...
You need comfort food.
And all that.
I'm with that.
But a pecan ice cream.
I can't have that.
Why?
What?
My allergies. I'm allergic to peanuts.
Dang.
Oh, man. So when you making your cakes, how do you do that without using... Any type of any like
well,
how does that work?
I use gloves and all that,
mm-hmm.
but with me, some people are like they can't touch it, be around it, or none of that. But I can, so like I could use it in my stuff
okay,
that I'm baking,
okay.
and I can still smell it and stuff.
You
but
just can't eat it,
right?
Okay.
Oh, that's what's up.
Well, I think you have found your niche, young man.
Thank you.
How's it going with you being in school and having this coronavirus thing going on? How's that working out for you?
It's
you
hard.
Like it?
Mm-mm.
No.
I don't. It's like I'm more of a hands-on learner, so I learn best when I'm there.
Hold on. Wait a minute. Where's his daddy? Where did y'all find this 12-year-old boy? He knows what he can and can't do. He knows what he best at. Like, who's 12? Where did they make 12-year-olds like you? I need to go buy me about 5 of them. Because you know you are. You, like, already know yourself. Like, you know who you are already. You, like, half a grown man sitting up here. No, he didn't. It be like that sometimes.
Yeah.
So what? You got social media people wanted to purchase your cakes or anything?
Tell them how to come to the Sugar Shack.
So you can get me on Facebook for from Joseph Thompson, but soon enough I'll be making a Facebook page for called Joe Sugar Shack, which is my business name, and that'll be my whole business page.
Huh? 12 years old and talk about business.
My man got business at 12. He got business at 12.
Man, but we definitely appreciate you for coming through. We definitely
Daddy, you come on, Dad, because I got to ask you this. I got to ask you. You ain't even got to come over here. You can just come on to the mic. I got to ask you this. Because this has to be a proud moment. How you feel that having a 12-year-old young man, that one, he is his own walking advertisement. Two, my man already know what he is and ain't. He know who he built to be. This had to come from somewhere, Daddy. What you do to this boy? Because I ain't met too many 12-year-olds. Where they make 12-year-olds like this? This man is already a half a grown man.
Well, like I've been told plenty of times, he's been born before he already been here.
Yeah, he got an old soul. That's a half grown man.
Yeah, I gotta remind him every once in a while that he's 12.
And not but, 19. Huh?
Exactly. Yeah, even older.
My man said he building an empire at 12.
Hey, get it there so I can retire. You know?
Yeah, exactly.
So, but he's around a lot of older people. He's the youngest of four, so he's around his older brothers. He got an older sister. He's always around my mom, and so he gets a lot of wisdom from other people.
Mama got him baking and making. They got him making money.
Look, I'll leave him in the kitchen. Most of my other kids, they older. I don't trust them in the kitchen. I'll just leave him right in the kitchen, and I'm gone. And he'll have some golden fried chicken and everything.
Oh, man, I'm coming to your house.
Come on through.
So this is my Christmas wish for you, right? They got a TV show called Young Chefs. I challenge you to be on that show by the end of next year. This is my Christmas wish from you. Okay. From me to you. This is what I want for Christmas. I
you
challenge you to be on that show.
They
got to
be mean to y'all. Be right there to help
you. Better
me
know
up.
It. Better know it. You go on the show, we going on that.
Hey, Ramsey, I'm listening to you because he's a hard boy. Hey, Ramsey.
Hey, like, you go on, like, we going on that bodyguard. So when he say the wrong thing, we got a headlock for him. So don't even worry about it. But next year, I challenge you to get on that show. Because what you doing right now, them kids on that show do the same thing. And you got the talent to do it.
And before I go, I want to ask you, Pops, as a father, and seeing like none of us went through this while we was young about the coronavirus. None of we always play activities and all that stuff. As a father, how do it feel when you're like, damn, my son can't go out or he can't be in school in those school programs? How does that make you keep up on the parenting more?
It's very tough, but I got to be even more lenient because even with his sister, they both transferring to another level of school, and it's tough doing school online. So the first couple semesters, I'm giving a little leeway because it's trial and error. But I feel for the kids because we got to play outside, go out here and do everything, but they got to be inside, which is tough on us parents because we have to be very strategic and have
stuff
to do.
Tough on the parents and the grocery bill go up, don't
you?
Oh,
my goodness. Let me ask you a hard question, right? Let me ask you the hard question. There ain't nobody asked yet. Most young boys grow up and they say, I want to play basketball. I want to be a football player. Your son grew up and said, I'm about to open this business and make these pies. How that make you feel?
Look, I just do my best to present as much as I can to them. Because I played football, basketball, stuff. I even coach football. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, it's their decision to what they want to do. And
don't
ever
you, because my son basically wanted to do the same thing. Like, you want to do what?
Right.
But I'm saying, my man said, look, y'all going to be hurting about 20 years. I'm going to be still baking these pies, and my knee's going to be good.
Well, as long as he ain't saying nothing, like, I...
It is your boyfriend on the beat.
Catch cold. Doing this forever, wherever we touch gold. Been doing this forever, wherever we touch gold. Nickel. Hold up, this only take a sec. Sometimes you gotta make these niggas recollect. Ha! I've been doing this forever, ask my nigga Step. Word to Martin Lawrence. Boy, this a run to left. Bow. Got so many hits, I'm feeling like I'm Jimmy Jam. I'm on a different wave, you wouldn't understand. Ha! I be out in London, you might catch me in Japan. Konnichiwa, bitch. I ain't speaking Spanish. Nah. Everything go, bitch, I'm Trinidad James. It's a cold world, but I'm dropping mad flames. Bye. They tell me take it easy, I should slow it down. I say don't wait till niggas die, give me my flowers now, bitch.
See them dudes I'm with, ain't friendly. And the juice I spit, make them envy.
Yeah, and I'm not new, stay on the radar, I got to. I will not lose, we different, nigga, I'm not you.
Nah.
Hot chew, I bless tracks, no tissue. So cool, cover your mouth, you'll catch cold. Doing this forever, wherever we touch gold. Been doing this forever, wherever we touch gold.
Yeah, tell me where the love went. Fuck the government. Russian sickle, figure four locks. Submit. Matter of fact, switch subjects. Democrats, Republicans, wanksters, shit, they all rubbish. My flavor profiles are fatter than Bronson. Give me some action, I'm the bomb, son. Eating raw fishes in Paris, France. Backstage, behind curtains, French missus taking a glance like. Bonjour. Bonsoir. You know, I'm a little rusty on my French, but, you know, voulez-vous? You know, what's that y'all like to do? Walking around the water, sipping cocoa. She made me come twice for good measure and good promo. Lady sang the blues till she met me. Gone from happy hour at park, now twerking on a jet ski. Painting walls, doing shots of Irish light, Pesci. I got a couple broads, I call them all my besties. Wink, wink, who's that? No one. Kiss, kiss, drink, drink. I chopped a few, Shogun.
Hold up, $2 for $1. Hey, hey, we be getting them all in free. We getting $2 for $1. Hey, check the foolishness. And who is she? Now I'm the type just wanna play fair though. Looking like she really wanna share. And the bottle say, Blake, Clico. And you know that the game is finito. Yes, I'm talking Menage. Yes, my name is Victoria. Show they swing my way. They want mucho grande. Plus it's $2 for $1. They get the whole entree. Tonight she be rolling,
tonight she be rolling,
and she got her head out.
She got her head out.
Them drinks they be pouring,
you gotta pour,
and we got it lit now.
Lit, lit.
We dancing on couches,
we on couches,
making a scene,
making a scene. We making a scene.
Hold up,
hold up. Making a scene.
Hold up,
hold up.
We making a scene.
Hold up,
hold up. They be liking them bennies, right?
We getting $2 for $1.
They be drinking that henny,
right?
$2 for $1.
Hey,
we be getting them all in free. We getting $2 for $1.
Red carpet swaggle, got my neck be on freeze. And I come through your spot and blow about 30 G's. And a venue can't afford us.
Nope.
Racks fat like a walrus. Guard your girl, man, she gorgeous.
Yeah.
Or it's Ultra Cinco on the tour bus.
What?
I said Ultra Cinco on the tour bus. I fucks with that thot cause she stops. She don't trip, that it's more of us. Up in VIP, if you with me, know I got you.
I got guacamole, fettuccine
racks.
Can't control me, wear too many hats.
Leave them lonely with them weenie cats.
Leave them lonely, straight Houdini acts.
Oof.
Popping bottles like a soda pop. No, she popping when them shoulders drop. Face down, you know, ass up. Now that type of ass you don't pass up.
She got the recipe.
Recipe.
She know my pedigree, she open sesame.
Yeah.
If she bring out the best in me, I might just make a shower. It's
$2 for $1.
They be liking them bennies,
right? We getting $2 for $1.
They be drinking a henny, right?
Oh, watch your mouth with the bass. All
right,
here we go.
We good.
What do you do, y'all? Welcome back to Christmas with the Stars, y'all. We want to jump in real quick and take a quick intermission. And we want to send some love out to Journey Williams and her family.
Yes.
They suffered a great loss last night, so we just want to let them know that our prayers are with them and that we're sending you some love. And even though you can't be here with us, Journey, baby, we are still loving on you.
Yes, we love you. We miss you. We wish you a happy, happy holidays. You and your family, our condolence to your family. We love you.
All the love we got.
Yes.
And with that being said, we're going to jump right back into it. So give us 2 seconds. We're going to take a quick little commercial, and we're going to be right back with all the new stuff going on.
That's right.
Welcome back to Christmas with the Stars. I'm your girl, Mimi Ottagaff. I am sitting here with Corey. Hi, pretty lady.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Tell the people your name, how old you are, and what school you go to.
I am Corey Michelle Horn. I'm 12 years old, and I go to Gwen Park Middle School.
Oh, I know what Gwen Park is. My kids used to go there. That's going to be lit. What grade you in?
I'm in 7th grade.
You in 7th grade. What's your favorite subject in school?
My favorite subject is English.
English?
Okay. What you want to do with that?
I mean, I often write essays. I often write my thoughts, write my, you know, my secrets in there.
So you want to be a story? You want to write stories or?
Well, with that being said, I like seeing my thoughts come to life. So that's why I want to be a designer.
Okay, okay. And you've done that from what I heard. You made some clothes and did that. Tell me the name of your clothing line.
Cori Michelle Collection.
The Cori Michelle Collection. So when people see your clothes, right?
Right.
When they see the Cori Michelle Collection, what you want them to think about? How you want them to feel when they have on your clothes and they walking down the street in the Cori Michelle Collection?
I want them to feel comfortable and I want them to feel like, I want them to feel great.
You want them to feel great. So are you hoping to just, you want a certain age range to wear your clothes or you want everybody wearing the Cori Michelle Collection?
I want the age range to increase as I get older, but okay. For now, I want kids to wear my clothes.
Just kids? So when we say kids, what grades are we talking about? We want kids in what grade group to wear our clothes? What we try to get?
Like from really young to like a young adult or teenager.
Okay, okay. And you feel like you got a little bit of something for all ages of kids?
I do.
Yeah, because if this jacket on the market, I might have to get that, and I ain't nobody kid, so I'm just letting you know. But I heard you got a model. You done made an outfit out here that's popping, because I seen it back then, and I was like, hold on, wait a minute, that look like something. I'm like, wait, you got a model out here, and I like her jacket. I want that jacket she got on, like, that look like Mimi all day. So let's see if we can get her to come through and do this walk, because she got a bad little walk right here. Yes, honey, yes. Go ahead and turn around and show the people the outfit, yes. So tell us a little bit about the outfit.
I made that in 2017. I was 9, my first fashion show.
Pause. Did you say you was 9 when you made that?
Yes.
And you're 12 now?
Yes, ma'am.
See, I'm gonna have to do some things with my life. Go ahead, mama.
I made that outfit in 2017, and I wanted her to wear something that I created, so I had to wear that.
That is pretty. How you feel when you put this on, little mama?
Very comfortable.
Very comfortable. It make you feel pretty?
Yes, ma'am.
You look very pretty in it. It looks very good on you.
Thank you.
So what do you like about her clothing? What do you like about her clothes?
I like about her clothes is that they're fun and they don't look too boring.
Mm-hmm.
They look very nice and also...
I like the colors. I like them colors.
Thank you.
And I like her designs on the fabric.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of other things.
Okay, how old are you?
9.
You're 9, and what's your name?
My name is Kylan Horn.
Kylan Horn, this your sister?
Yes, sir.
Oh, man, what school do you go to?
I go to Brandywine Elementary.
Girl, you started off the right way. The best person to use is your sister. That's like your walking billboard right there. And she already got all the reasons why she like your stuff. Probably more reasons than you ever thought, huh?
Yes, sir.
See, look, you never know. Your biggest support could sometimes be the person right next to you, which is your sister. And so, what made you say, you know what, I want to design clothes? What made you say, this is what I want to do?
I mean, I wanted to start designing clothes because I've always been one for art. I always loved it. And when I was 9, when I was 8, I went to my mom and I told her that I wanted to be a fashion designer. And it didn't take too long for her to say, let's have a fashion show.
Oh, okay, mom. Shout out to moms for being the big supporter. Yes, that's right, mom. Support that baby dream. So what's next for you?
In 2021, I want to start my own business.
Mm-hmm.
I want to have a website where you can buy my clothes,
mm-hmm.
and that's how I want to start off.
So that's your, so tell the people how they can find you right now to be a part of the Cori Michelle Collection. Tell the people how they can find you.
My parents have an organization called the HornInitiative.org, and you can see me, it says Cori's Collection, and you can see my designs down there, and you can come in contact with my parents from there.
Period. Talk to her mama and daddy, not her. That was the whole point of this conversation. With that being said, I am proud of you, young lady.
Thank you.
So if you could get one thing for Christmas in the whole wide world that Santa Claus would bring you for Christmas. Don't mess up my fantasy. Mm-mm. Don't mess up my fantasy. Yes, I said Santa Claus. One thing in the whole world that Santa Claus could bring you, what would it be?
I mean...
I ain't say it was no limits on it. I said whatever you wanted.
What he can give me?
Yeah, what Santa got you? Whatever he could bring you. One thing you want that Santa could drop off at your house. And if it was anything in the world that you wanted that Santa could bring you on Christmas Day, what would it be?
The mansion of my choice.
Oh, okay, hold on. Well, she said the mansion of her choice. I hope your mansion come paid for, because I need mine paid for when he drop it off. That's what's up. So, in 5 years, what do you see happening with your business? In 5 years.
I want it to increase a lot more. I don't think I should be like an adult or really older to start.
You'll be 17 in 5 years. So at 17, where do you see the Corey Michelle collection being?
I want to be an entrepreneur. Oh, my goodness.
An entrepreneur. I got you.
An entrepreneur, a mogul, a designer. I want to be a CEO of my own company.
Oh, you trying to be on your Kylie Jenner. Okay, yes, I'm with it. That's what I'm talking about. Well, Merry Christmas, my love.
Thank you.
Let me ask you one question. I got one question for you. If Santa Claus could bring you one thing in the whole wide world, what would it be? See, I ain't do that, Santa. Don't put that on me. I just asked, and that was her answer. Don't put that on me. I still need my presents on Christmas. Don't do that. But I'm just saying. With that being said, y'all, thank y'all so much for coming and talking to me. You are very beautiful in your outfit, ma'am.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, all that good stuff. And you know, when you get big and popping and you ready for the new collection, you know, ready to step up to the big grown people, let me know. I'm going to come holler at you.
Okay.
All right? All right. And with that being said, y'all, we're going to be right back and get into some more interviews, y'all. We'll be right back. You did good.
Get down. Come on, man. Look at my roof. Look at my roof. You play too much. Now, if I get into it with them, I got to live here and you don't. Get out the way. Move. Just move.
Christmas with the Stars. I'm your girl, Mimi Ottagaff, along with your man, Bam 640.
You did. What's and up, young? You nervous?
What it do, Angel? What it do? Talking to Mike. How you doing?
Good.
Good. How old are you?
Five.
Man, look, the last time I seen you, Angel, you was in here breakdancing and getting it on with Bruno Mars. Like, you know what I'm saying? You still dancing?
Yeah.
What made you want to dance? What makes you be like, I want to be a dancer?
I just do it.
You just do it. You just woke up like that. You just woke up and your feet started moving.
Man, you ready, man. You ready.
So when you get big, you want to be a dancer? Or what you want to do when you get big? What do you want to do?
A singer.
You want to be a singer? So you going to be, so you trying to be like Chris Brown out here in these streets? Yeah. Who you like when you listen to music? Who you want to be like when you get famous? Who you want to be like?
I want to be like Michael Jackson.
Oh, that's the man. That's who you're supposed to be like.
Yeah.
So you know how to moonwalk and all that? Yeah? Oh, you want to show me that. You know how to do the moonwalk? I don't even know how to do the moonwalk, man. I can't do that. I can do it in my socks, though. If I do it in my socks, I can slide. What's your favorite Michael Jackson song?
Talk to the mic.
Billie Jean.
Oh, hold on, wait a minute.
Why are you like three? And Billie Jean is your favorite Michael Jackson song. Wait a minute, Jesus. Great. Where is your grandma? I'm about to get her. My man said Billie Jean is his favorite Michael Jackson song.
That's your favorite Michael Jackson song?
Look, ma'am is stuck. Like, wait a minute.
Out of all the songs, Billie Jean.
I thought my man was going to say bad.
Did you really just tell me Billie Jean?
Not Billie Jean, huh? What you like about Billie Jean? I'm curious now. We done started it. Let's get into it. What you like about Billie Jean? Why you like that song?
I just like it because I do the moonwalk.
Oh, you like it because you can do the moonwalk. So you like the beat, not the words. Huh? You like the music, not the words.
You keep moving your feet. I thought you said you weren't nervous.
I wasn't.
You wasn't, but now the little things have changed a little bit, huh? Respect. Go ahead.
So what school you go to, Angel?
Park Ridge Elementary.
Park Ridge Elementary. What do you like to do in school?
Just do it and have fun.
Just do it and have fun. You have fun in everything you do in school. What's your favorite subject in school? What's the favorite thing that you learn in school?
You got a favorite subject.
Hey, look, math. Some five-year-olds, true. What's your favorite thing that you do in school?
Math.
Math. That's your favorite thing to do?
You all about the money.
Okay. He's trying to learn how to count this money. So, let's see. Who is your favorite teacher in school?
And don't say BAM 640 because I'm not there.
Miss Cook.
Miss Cook is your favorite teacher? Why you like Miss Cook so much?
Because she don't give me a lot of work.
Oh, that's what I'm talking about, baby. Be honest. That's right. So, how do you like going to school online? Do you like it more than being in school?
Yes.
You like being at home and doing school? Yeah?
Sometimes it's boring.
Sometimes it's boring. But you happy you don't have to wake up early and go to school no more? No? You be going to school in your pajamas, man?
Yes.
Man, this guy, man, look. So you gonna dance today? On what song? Let me guess. Billie Jean. Oh, excuse me.
Oh, you was wrong. You Bruno Mars in it today? You can give us some Bruno. No, what you dancing to, man?
Dancing machine.
Oh, you a dancing machine today? Oh, I can't wait. This about to be lit. He about to give us the rope. Oh man. Hey look. After you done, right? I'ma catch you on our side of town. We gonna have to get our Michael Jackson dance on, okay? All right. I'ma come holler at you at my mother's house later on. We gonna get our moonwalk on, okay? All right. So I'm saying though, man, what you want for Christmas, man?
Basketball.
You want a basketball for Christmas?
What else? That's it?
What else? Why he looked at grandma like, I don't know. Careful what I say. She might not back.
A football?
You want a football? So you want all the sports equipment.
Who your favorite football team?
The Washington football
get
team.
That's right, baby. That's right. He said the Washington football, and he said it the right way. That's right, baby.
Get up right now. Your time is now.
You good? Don't be letting him run you off like that. Tell Bam, be easy. Tell him, son, say be easy, man.
Why you like that team? Of all the teams.
It's good.
Because they good.
They good? Really? Well, I'm a Cowboy fan.
Who told you to watch that football team was good? Who told you that?
My dad.
Oh, okay. That's how you get the truth.
All right, okay. I just wanted to know.
Your daddy told you to say that on TV, right? Oh, okay. There we go. That's how we know. He said, represent my team when you go on there, son. So I'm saying though, man, you ready to perform in a little while?
Yeah.
You nervous? You scared?
No.
Nope, you ready to just do the thing. You just ready, huh? Okay. We're like, we're going to do one more interview, and then we're going to let you get out here and do your thing, okay?
Before I go, I got to say, hold on, we're going to put his grandma up here, right? See, I got some information on you for the last couple of weeks, right?
Ooh, Bam been playing spy.
And you've been stressing me out, you know that? Nah, I ain't playing. I'm just, you ain't stressing me out.
Bam was
no,
right.
No, put his grandma up. I'm going to tell you what I wanted to do, right? Come on, you come up here and talk. Come here.
Come on, Ma.
I'm going to tell you. And
girl, come on,
really,
show off them llamas. Come on.
Really do this.
Come on and show off them llamas.
Grandmas love you, and grandma been raising you, and yes. y'all been doing a lot. That bag right there on that table.
That one right there.
Yeah.
That's for you.
And that bag. And
that's
for you. Right there. So this was what Cozy
that's
Radio
for
did for you. Me, Brandon Moore, and me, this is what we did for you. Right?
Cause I this got for you, too.
So, I'm going to give this to your grandmother. You can't open it now, though, right? But all these are yours, okay? So we're going to make sure you have a Merry Christmas, okay?
So that is from Miss Tamika Joy and the Stars program. Mr. Brandon Moon right there.
Yeah.
You and Mr. Bam and me. And where's Mr. Brian? And the Cozy Radio Show. All of us here, we are all here to wish you a very Merry Christmas.
And those are yours.
And those are yours to take home and open on Christmas, okay?
Okay.
All right. So what you want to say to Mr. Moon and Mr. Bam and Miss Tamika? What you want to tell them? Well, you better use the manners.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yes.
You're welcome. We're going to be right back, man. It's from Cozy Radio. This is what we do. We like to
thank
give back
you,
to
everyone.
You. We like to give back to the community. And that's what we did.
And so we'll be back, y'all.
Yeah.
You ready?
Let's go. Uptown. Shake it, baby. Work it, baby. Bounce it. Bounce it. Bounce it. Bounce it. I'm not afraid to
cause he left out. Sing with me. You can't leave cause your heart is here, but you're trying anyway.
What it do, what it do? We are back. The Christmas with the Stars. We got Mr. Moon in the building. Came
up,
through man? To hang out with the kids.
What's
and
up, man?
Get it in. And Miss Star. We got Miss Micah Star. She is a singing, dancing somebody. She is, I mean, let's just put it out there. That's Tamika Star, baby. So what more do we need to say? All her babies got talent. We're going to make a show called Tamika Kids Got Talent. What's going on, boo? Welcome back. You came back to get your pop lock on with us again? Maybe. Oh, let me, yeah, we got, because you know, you giving us little voice, so we got to make you loud. So tell the people who you are. Say that beautiful name out loud. Micah. You got to give us the whole name, girl. You know you got a famous name. Don't be acting like that. Yes, honey. That's a fact. Look, she already famous. She ain't even got to change her name. That name ready just to be printed. Her name is Micah Star. Know her. So I'm saying that. What you doing for us today? Since you told me maybe. What you doing for me today?
Dancing.
You dancing? What you dancing to?
Here Comes Santa Claus.
Here Comes Santa Claus. I like this outfit you got on. That is cute.
Thank you.
That's real cute. It's all sparkly. It got me in the Christmas spirit. So I'm saying, though, what school you go to?
Potomac Landing, but I'm homeschooled right now.
You homeschooled right now? How are you liking that?
A little bit.
You been making sure you logging in every day, doing your work?
Well, I don't go on Zoom. My mom teaches me.
I
think I'm about to pray for your mama. Yeah, you don't got to go on the Zoom, so you don't have to be in there listening to all the kids be hard-headed and stuff. Your mama got you. She hooking you up.
Yeah.
So you like it better with your mama teaching you versus going to school?
Yeah.
Is it harder with your mama teaching you versus the teachers?
A little bit.
Are you learning the same things or different things?
Not the same things.
Okay.
You said it's a little bit easier with your mama teaching you or harder?
A little easier.
It's a little easier. Why is it easier with your mama teaching you versus the teachers?
Because you don't have to get dressed or you just do it from your book.
So you going to school in your pajamas too?
Yeah.
Oh, y'all just wrong out here. Y'all wrong for the school day. Y'all know y'all supposed to at least put a shirt on. They can see y'all from, you know, up here. You supposed to at least put a regular shirt on and keep the pajama pants on.
Well, I keep a shirt on and shorts.
Oh, she in the school like she in the summertime. So what's your favorite subject in school?
Math.
Everybody's favorite subject is math. That was not the subject when I was in school. Didn't nobody want to go to math. Everybody wanted to go to PE.
Exactly.
Right. Well, everybody wanted to go to PE. And when they wasn't saying PE, they was like, my favorite subject is lunch. Well, I didn't even know that was a subject. I was like, lunch is a subject? So I'm saying, though, so math is your favorite subject. What's your favorite thing about math outside of money?
I don't really know.
Oh, so money is your favorite subject. Is that what you're trying to tell me?
Yeah, and gym.
Money and gym. What do you like about gym?
That you get to run around the gym class.
That baby says she need freedom.
Right. Do you have an idea of what you want to be when you grow up?
Yeah.
What?
A gamer.
A gamer?
My daughter says she want to be the same thing, though. That's crazy.
You want to get paid to play video games, or you want to design the video games?
Or you want to be a streamer?
Well, I want to get paid.
The game in the living room.
Right. Well, not really, but me and my cousin are going to be gamers.
Y'all are going to be gamers. Okay. So which one of y'all going to design the video game, though? You know, it's money and design in the game.
I don't really know about that.
You don't know about that? Don't worry about that. You just want to play the game. Okay, I'm with it. Hey, whatever works.
As long as you get paid.
Right, period, the end. So let me ask you a question. What we gonna do with this dancing talent? Like, you got dancing talent, singing talent, and you wanna play video games. Like, what is we gonna do with this?
I don't know.
You don't know? I'm saying that sounds like a good video game. You make us a game where we can sing and dance. We might be in business.
What inspired you to dance?
My sister.
Your sister?
You dance all the time and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool.
Okay. So I'm saying though, how you feel about this TikTok thing? You a TikTok fanatic? Like you love you some TikTok too?
Yeah.
You know all the TikTok dances?
Not really.
No, I was going to say, so what you going to do when they take TikTok away? When they be like, it's a ban on TikTok, what you going to do? You going to lose your mind, ain't you?
Not really.
No? You going to be all right? When they stop y'all from doing all the TikToks, you going to be all right?
A little bit.
She said a little bit. I'm going to be a little bit all right. So how do you feel about this coronavirus thing? How you feel about it? How is coronavirus making you feel? Having to be in the house, you can't be around your friends, you can't have a birthday party the way you want to, blow it all up, go all out, you can't do none of that. How you feel about that?
Well, it's sad because we have to wear masks, and I don't like wearing masks.
You don't like wearing a mask? Why you don't like that?
Because it covers your face from talking and... the little straps on them. It's annoying. On my ears.
It's
a little sketchy.
So you just ready for the whole coronavirus thing to be done so you can show your beautiful face?
Yes.
Okay. I understand. Trust me. I be like, look. Walk around. So you try walking up the stairs with the mask on to see how I be. I'm too old for this. My lungs is not the same. So. How do you think the summer's gonna be with everybody having to wear a mask and we can't go to summer camps and we can't go traveling? Like, what you gonna do, man? What you gonna do about the summer?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Probably just stay in the house.
Aw, so if you had one wish for Christmas, what would it be? If you could give one gift to the whole world for Christmas, if you can make one wish, and your one wish would be a gift for the whole world, what would your one gift be?
Money.
Money? You giving everybody money. Oh, I like her. Santa Claus, holler at her.
No,
we need
that. You know what comes with money. What would you do with your money? You know you got to be smart with money.
Yeah.
So Santa Claus just started dropping off $1,000 to everybody. He's just dropping off thousands and thousands of dollars. He drop, knock at your door and be like, hey, $5,000. What you gonna do with your money?
Save it.
Girl, see, I like you. That's what I'm talking about. Yes, girl. That's what I'm talking about. Smart girls run the world. That's what I'm talking about. She said, I'm gonna save this money. She ain't trying to go to the candy store. She ain't trying to go to the ice cream truck. She gonna hold on to it.
Right.
Because I get paid to do chores.
Oh, you get paid to do your chores? Oh, girl, you got the sweet life. Ain't nobody paid me to get to do no chores. Now, hold on. I ain't get paid to do my chores. You got the sweet life. You getting paid to do chores?
Yeah.
Oh, man. You balling out here.
Does that teach you responsibility?
Yeah.
Do you feel like everybody should get paid to do their chores?
Yes.
Yes? Yes?
That's
okay.
True. Everybody should be compensated for work.
Hey, she said, if I do these chores, if I wash these dishes,
right.
I need this $5.
I need to be compensated.
Like right now. That's what's up.
Straight up.
Oh, you got a credit card? Oh, you just swiping it. They cash apping you your money, huh? That's what I'm talking about. Shorty said, I need my money on time, right now.
That's what I'm talking about.
She ain't got to wait.
Yeah, right.
She said, I ain't got to wait for you to go to the ATM, nothing. You can go ahead and send that to my card. I'm good.
Facts.
So, what you want? So, you said you want to be a gamer when you grow up. And you gonna figure out this dancing, singing thing later on because you only was doing that because your sisters was doing that. So, let's see. 5 years, you will be how old? How old are you now?
9.
You're 9. So, in 5 years, you gonna be half a grown woman in 5 years. You ready to get out there and start working and helping your mama?
Yeah. That she takes care of me?
That's the best thing that she can do is take care of you. That is the greatest thing ever is the fact that she takes care of you and you can say it with a smile. Right. That is a great thing because that means mommy holds you down. So with that being said, give your shout outs. Tell everybody happy Merry Christmas and all that great stuff.
Merry Christmas.
And you gonna, who you shouting out? Get a shout out. You know what I'm saying? You got the whole gang squad up in here. Go ahead and get a shout out. Right. Mm-hmm. All your fans in here, girl. Get a shout out. Mm-hmm. She said, I don't know if I like y'all like that. But,
You want to shout out the fam?
You can just say shout out to all them over there in the corner.
Tragic, Cherish, Mom, Malachi, Shade. Tatiana.
Yeah. I'm actually pointing at y'all like this, then.
Yeah, Diva here. That's good.
These dudes. These guys. She was like, this dude. All y'all. Gang, gang. Squad, squad. With that being said, we're going to let you go ahead and get ready because you about to come back and, you know, get your dance on and get us started and all that great stuff. So we're going to take a quick break, get things set up for the performances part, and we'll be right back after this last interview, y'all. Let's go. All right. We got one more. Jump right into the performances. Hello, beautiful.
Hello.
Miss Tatiana J is in the building.
Yes, I am.
I heard you are a songbird, boo.
I mean, you know.
You know. You make it do what it do, boo. Oh, hi. This is going to get interesting. So, I was just saying, though, what made you say, okay, I can sing, I can do that. I'm cute and I can sing. I can do all that.
I mean, life made me do that. Life catch up to you.
I like her little... I like this little movement thing she got going on. You said life catch up to you. How old are you?
I'm 17.
And you said life caught up to you.
Yes, it did.
At 17.
Really fast.
At 17.
Yes, it did.
Life caught up to you.
Yes, it did.
Okay, so I'm curious. You got my
interest. I mean, you know, everybody go through what they go through. You know, sometimes people got to grow up faster than what they need to be. So I had to find myself in something that, you know, would keep me sane, grounded. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Okay, so... Tell us a little bit about that journey. Tell us about that learning how at 17 years old, learning how to keep yourself grounded and not just be out here acting crazy like you could be. Because, you know, some of us at 17, we was like, I'm ground. And just, you know,
I mean, but you're not. I feel like life is like high school. You could lose yourself anywhere in any group. So I feel like you just have to stick to yourself and let people come to you. So,
okay.
I mean, I'm 17. I feel like... Nobody.
She's 17, but she sounds like she's 25. I got real interested. Yeah. Like, let me pull my chair out. I might learn something today.
Yeah, no, I feel like, you know, pain, not a bad thing. You know, you learn from it, but I feel like for everybody, pain is universal. So everybody feel it differently, and somebody's story may be bigger or small, but everybody feel pain. So it made me, like, grow up and find music and everything else that I may do.
Okay, ain't nothing wrong with that.
At all.
It's nothing wrong with that. And you're 100% correct. Sometimes at 17, heck, at 16 sometimes, you just got to grow up. And it ain't always because you make a mistake. Sometimes life just brings things our way that we got to learn how to just pick ourselves up and stand on them 10 toes and figure it out.
Yeah.
And you seem to be doing that.
Yeah.
So how are we still in school? Like, what we doing?
Unfortunately. Yes, I'm still in school. Oh, no, she didn't say unfortunately. Unfortunately, my bad.
So are we on our way out the door? You should be on your way out the door.
Yes, I'm on my way out.
Girl, what you complaining for? You done.
Because it's different. It got hard real quick.
It got hard?
Yes.
What part got hard? Was it the fact that you couldn't go to school?
No. Yeah. It was the fact that we
But you know, y'all 17-year-olds, you know, I used to work in high school, you know, at 17, y'all become annoying. We be waiting on y'all to get out school. Like, y'all become the seniors, y'all want to run around the ground, tell my hallways.
Uh-huh, and we're waiting to get out the school.
And we waiting on y'all to get out. We be every day, like, 3 o'clock ain't get hit fast enough.
It's a great relationship.
I know, right?
You want me out, I want to get out.
She said, you want me out, I want to get out.
It's great.
That's what's up. So how is learning online? Knowing that this is your last year. Matter of fact, how is it knowing that, this is your last year? You're not going to have no real graduation. We can't walk. We can't get y'all to graduation parties. We can't let y'all walk across the stage.
Yeah.
Is that, like, the one thing that everybody's looking for? Like, is that the one thing, like, everybody, when they graduate high school, is that, like, you're like, I'm going through cap and gown. I'm going to walk this stage.
I mean,
like,
I can't get upset about something that I never went through. I mean, it looks nice. But I can't really be too upset. Yeah, like, I can't. I only way, because music take a very long time to, you know, become what you work off of to make life on. So I don't want to get out and be like, I'm going to just get music and not do work, not do school. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, but music for sure.
So what's your passion? What are you, outside of music and being an artist, who is Tatiana J? Like, who are you? Outside of music, outside of your artistry, who are you?
I'm trying to figure that out.
At 17, you're trying to figure that out right now?
Yeah, I can't say who I am right now, but I love people. I like helping people. Mm-hmm. You know, I love doing stuff like this. Like, I love being here.
That's what's up. Just I love her. Cause, she's too funny. So let me say this to you. You are a very beautiful girl.
Thank you very much.
And from what I hear, you are very talented.
Thank you
so
very
I will
much.
Give you this advice. Mm-hmm. From a young woman to a young woman. Where you're headed, very many people are not going to be able to go. Mm-hmm. And where you're going can only be meant for you to go. Mm-hmm. So with that being said, keep your eyes open. Stay true to yourself. And being true to yourself means defining yourself for yourself, not anyone else's definition of you.
Right.
As long as you stay true to who you are, can't do no wrong following your dreams, boo. All right?
Yeah.
So with that being said, I have one more question for you, and then we're going to get out of here and jump into these performances.
Okay.
Your one wish, if you could get anything you wanted in the world for Christmas, no limitations, what would that be?
For some doors to be open. A lot of doors, you know, different opportunities. And, yeah, I want to finish my album. That's what I want to do.
Hey, DMV.
Yeah.
Y'all got the ability.
Now is the part of the show that we get to the good part. Started performance. Thanks to everybody for tuning in. We got these performers going to be back to back, back to back, back to back. I think we got like 4 or 5. So, my man Angel, you ready, huh?
Yeah.
Tell them what you're going to do today.
Dance.
Dance or what?
Dancing machine.
Okay. You ready? I'm going to get out the way, y'all, man. Y'all, this is my man Andrew Jenkins, man. This is one of our new homies, man. We're going to be kicking it out the show and everything. Let's go.
She's moving, she's grooving, dancing until the music stops now. Yeah.
Did that. All right, Angel, I'm going to have to come and get some of them dance lessons from you. Get this dancing machine on. He did that. Y'all ain't see that? That's what he did. Boy, my knees. So we're going to take a quick intermission, so I'm going to come back and we're going to have some conversations, y'all, real quick. So as we all know, yo, it is the holidays. It is a lot of people around the world who are struggling to create and provide for their families. There are a lot of people in the world who are struggling to give gifts for their families, and we are here trying to provide that with the Stars and Miss Tamika Joy. We got plenty of gifts to give out, plenty of performances coming through. Of course, Mr. Angel just came through and gave us his good old dancing machine. You ready, Miss Micah? Let's do it. Come on, boo. I know, it never is. They special.
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
Here comes Santa Claus, bright down Santa as we dream by the fire,
Santa Claus.
To face unafraid the plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland. Ain't it thrilling? Oh, you know, it's a chilling. We'll frolic and play the Eskimo way. Walking in the winter wonderland. When it snows.
Hey, see now, but your legs. It's because the kids are shorter than me, so we try and make sure that the stuff is leveled out for the children. But what we're going to do is we're going to get Miss Tatiana J up here. She's going to perform This Christmas for Us, which is, like I said, one of my favorite Christmas songs ever. I'm going to be in the background two-stepping, so let's get it popping. Come on, boo.
Fun is gonna be together this Christmas. The fireside is blazing bright, and we caroling through the the fireside is blazing.
for you and me, yeah, baby. We'll be together and make this Christmas bright. Yes, we will.
Thank you, Mom.
Period, 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 period.
Yes, but tell them again. You did
period.
That. Period, Pooh.
Thank you.
You did that. High five. With your singing self. Yes, girl. That's what I'm talking about. So, you know, this like my favorite part, right? Because I get my two babies to come up here. And y'all sing for me. This makes me feel so good with my whole life. So, Treasure, and come on, Boo. Yeah, come on. You singing? Come on. And you come on too. Oh, Sean, what I'm saying, you acting brand new today? Okay, it's all right. I'm gonna catch you on the way outside. You gonna sing for me before you leave here. We got one here. We got one there. One of y'all taller than the other one. You tall right now.
She tall right now.
Don't be a hater. Why you?
No more than emotionally invested. Showing you all my imperfections.
If I let you, you'll take me for granted. Yeah. If I were more than you could manage, yeah.
Open with me, oh, we can be honest. Closer to me, oh, giving me solace.
Promise that you won't let me fall.
Holding me tight, loving me right, giving me life. All night you could be telling me lies, making me cry, wasting my time the whole time. So just be
careful what you take for granted, yeah. Cause with me, no, you could do damage. You
can do damage, you can do damage, yeah. Not worry about it, I'm putting pressure. You only cut me if I let you.
No, she ain't the one, it's just for pleasure.
Either love me or I'm a lesson.
No. Want me, don't take me for granted. Yeah, yeah. If I'm worth more than you could manage, baby.
Oh, you're falling for me. Oh, baby, I've caught it. Ooh, we could be whatever you want, call it.
Promise that you won't let me fall.
Oh. Holding me tight, loving me right, giving me life. All night you could be telling me lies, making me cry, wasting my time the whole time. So just be
careful what you take for granted. Yeah,
no.
Cause with me, no, you could do damage.
You can do damage, yeah.
You could do damage. You can do damage, yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna throw my shoe right quick.
Like, good body. I already, you know, girl. Like, you know it. Oh, my goodness. Well, good God almighty, young man. It take a strong young man to stand up here and sing with her. That's a powerhouse body herself. You a bad man. You stood up here and hung out here with her. You was a bad man. Because I wouldn't even do that. And with that being said, y'all, we're going to get into all the fun, y'all. Y'all ready? Y'all ready? Let's start giving away some gifts. Y'all ready?
Okay.
Hey, ma'am. Y'all ready? We're going to start giving away some gifts. Moon, we ready? All right. Let's get this gift giving on. Let's go. Come on, everybody. Come on up here. Why y'all standing there looking like I ain't talking to y'all? Shim on. In the words of Michael Jackson, shim on. Let's go. Come on, Angel. You know these words. Come on. Shim on. Shim on, Cletus.
Gotcha.
Shimon, light skin.
Gotcha.
Shimon.
Gotcha, Angel.
Look, ain't nobody asking you to dance or sing. Bring your booty. Anybody asking you to dance or sing, bring your booty. Just come up here and be cute. Just come on up here and be cute. You too. Come on. Bring your butt and be cute. That's all we asking. Just be cute. And with that being said, bam, take it away.
Okay, we got all the kids up here. I didn't expect that, though. But while Mimi going to get the gifts, tell the people your name again.
Angel.
What's your name?
Malachi.
And y'all know all the grown people back there, junior grown people. So you excited about Christmas? Huh? You excited?
Yeah.
Why you excited about Christmas? Tell me why.
Because I like it.
Yeah, hey, look, that's a good enough answer, man. All right, Mimi.
So, everybody, y'all, we want to just bring y'all up here, let everybody see y'all beautiful faces, tell y'all thank y'all so much for hanging out with us, and come on, boo, with that beautiful, colorful, just, I love all of this. You just got me so in the holiday spirit. Right, but let me tell you something. Next time you shake your little booty, we fighting. We had everybody back there like, this she just, huh? Lucky I couldn't find my throat taste enough. I was going to get you. But thank y'all for coming and sharing y'all talents with us and supporting and just the whole nine yards. We are grateful for y'all coming and spending the holiday with us. Even though you just showed your face, you made me feel good because you know you my boo. You know what I'm saying? You know you my boo, girl. And with all that being said, y'all, Mr. Moon, tell the kids. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got the crew, the kids that came through, right. Did they thing,
yeah,
did
definitely, they talent. I definitely appreciate y'all coming on here. That you have to be a brave soul to even come here and express your talents. And this is what we built this platform for young people to come up here and be able to be them and not just feel like they have to be in the streets or this is the type of life I have to live. If I have a talent, I have somewhere that I can perform my talent. So I just want to thank y'all for just coming up here and being brave and being positive young people.
And Mr. Mika, you want to come give your thanks and appreciations to the babies?
Thank you, baby. Thank y'all, seriously, from the bottom of my heart, from Stars, as we are building and growing. And really, I'm out of breath because I was running. But I'm trying to love on you guys, showing you guys a platform, giving y'all an opportunity. Stuff that I wasn't blessed to get. Now that I have a position to do that, I'll make sure that you guys get what's better than I got. So thank you again.
And with that being said, y'all, we love y'all. Thank y'all for coming out and hanging out with us. Bam, tell the people they gonna catch us.
Hey, man, every Saturday right here, 6 to 8, man. Cozy Radio, my man Moon be back next Saturday. This is the platform that he built.
The gang's all here.
This is his vision, and he just let me drive the keys to it, and we always want to give back. We always want to show our thanks, appreciation, because this is bigger than us. It's more about the community. We just don't get in here and say, oh, man, we want to be in radio for people to see us. We want to present a lane that these kids don't have that some other shows might miss. So this is what we like to do. This is like we like to give back. We know it's been hard for y'all kids and our kids and everybody kids across the world. So we just wanted to shine our light on y'all, even let y'all know it's about y'all. I didn't have no guests. Y'all took over my show.
Right.
Y'all took off the show.
And, like, real quick, though, because y'all know I'm always doing something random. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4. Mm-hmm. Mr. Man said right here he can sing. I'm trying to get one of these Christmas carols up off of y'all. Like, how y'all going to act? I'm trying to get one of these Christmas carols up off of y'all. How y'all going to act? Like, it's the whole gang, squad right here. What's that? Jingle bells. Like, jingle bells. It's real easy. Everybody know jingle bells. Let's rock it out. Y'all better give me the trap version. Hey, let's go. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Okay. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one horse open sleigh. Hey. Rushing through the snow. One time. One horse open sleigh. Okay. All the moons we go. Let's go. Laughing all the way. Ha, ha, ha. Bells on the top ring. Hey. Making spirits bright. Okay. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Get the money.